Hello, here we are. I love this is my fa this is my favorite time of the month because we get so just so you know, we've got Italy here, we've got South Africa here,
Wow.
Bali here, we've got the rest of us here in Aussie, but we've got now we've got two South Australians. So hello, South Australia. We've got one Western Australian here. And the rest of us are Victorians. Is that correct? Yeah, we are definitely a global community. There is no doubt about it. And so it's always amazing just to be in a room, despite the fact that we're traversing the globe. Isn't that amazing? I mean, a lot of frustrating things about technology, but let me tell you, this is the thing I love about it the most, that we can do this. And so welcome everyone. And I'm excited because I know last time we spoke, it was October, and hello Sabrina, and leading into November. November is a month for writers, and I know Jen, we're looking forward to hearing about your progress with your NaNoWriMo, and yeah, just to hear. And I know Kat's doing her thing as well, and we've got Justin and Sue who have signed, send photos of them signing their publishing contract for their book, which is
Thank
incredibly
you.
exciting. We've got, oh, I don't know, just so much cool stuff. And I know Alice and I did a podcast recently, which we're actually launching it tomorrow. So Alice, podcast. So you get to hear Alice's story, which is pretty amazing. So lots. And we've got Terry here for the first time. So welcome, Terry. You have to unmute yourself, Terry.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
And well, welcome. And I know just arriving on the scene is Sean. You there, Sean?
Hi, Andrew. Yes, I just
Hello.
turned on my camera. Sorry.
Good to have you here, mate. It's awesome. There he is. So everyone, so what we're going to do, for those that are here for the first time, this is called an open forum, which means I've got no idea what's going to happen. All I know, this is one thing I do know. I trust me, you'll get to the end of this and you go, I'm so glad I attended. I mean, put your hand up if you've been to one of these and at least once you've thought, I'm so glad I was there. So me every time. And I started doing these when COVID hit. And I think the first one was probably March or April 2020. And I'm thinking, okay, how do we keep people together? How do we handle this situation? And so this started, and I didn't know how long this was going to go for. And now this is 3.5 years down the track. And every month we have not missed a month. And I do it for me. If I'm being brutally selfish, you guys fill my cup. And I know that we fill each other's cup. So I'm just going to throw it open, and I know we've got a couple of newbies, and I'm not going to, there's certainly no pressure to contribute, but if Sean, Terry, Alice, you were here, you did the Saturday morning one, didn't you? This is or were you here last month on this Tuesday one as well? Yeah, so yeah, Alice,
Yes.
you're no longer, and you're not a virgin to these anymore. But if anyone, Terry, if you feel like just introducing yourself, or Sean, if you'd like to introduce yourself, that's just an invitation, not a requirement. We'd love to hear from you.
As long as they promise not to run away, it's okay.
Can't
Only
run.
joking.
We
No. Only
can't run.
joking.
We're
Only
on
joking.
Zoom.
Oh, I hate this, but there's no one. Okay, so my name is Terry Bahat. I know Andrew from a different time and space, but now I'm here and I'd like to learn as much as I can about promoting and writing and speaking and all these wonderful things he knows, and I want to know too. That's in one sentence.
That's well, beautifully said too. And Terry, you didn't say you are a published author. So
I am, I am, I
you
am,
are a
I am, I
published
am,
author.
I
So
am, I am.
Terry works in health and fitness, and her passion is inspiring people to live happy, healthy lives, women in
Women,
particular.
women,
Yeah, women
yes.
in particular. So yeah, we spoke yesterday, didn't we? And I said, Terry, you've got to come into this meeting. And look at her, she did, because she wants to learn how to promote and market and sell a book. So I'm sure we'll get some ideas. You'll get some great ideas, Terry, from this session. So, hello, Sue. So, just add, let's just add another country to the mix. Sue's in England. So welcome. Is it chilly over there, Sue? You've got your beanie on.
Yeah, it's been a bit chilly. It's been colder, so not warm.
Yeah.
Oh, we've got two. You've got two Sue. That's nice to
Yes, there's two Sues. There's Aussie Sue and there's English Sue.
Oh, okay. We'll forgive
you. Both beautiful people, both inspiring individuals, just at opposite ends of the world. Okay. Anyone else want to? Sean, just an invitation if you would like to, but if you don't, you can say no. Just a quick intro.
Oh, yep, sure, Andrew. Hi, everyone. My name is Sean Nikukar. I run a business as a managing consulting, and I met Andrew, which is great. I attended in one of his events, and then we had chat and discuss about writing book, and it is in my plan. Hopefully, finger crossed, touch the wood, it will happen.
Will happen, mate. You don't need to cross your fingers.
Yeah,
you'll do it, Sean. There might be a couple from you. So Sean was in the event. Sue and Justin were at the same event. This was in last month, so I don't think there's anyone else here. Hello, Judy.
Hello. Sorry, I'm late. I had a Zoom meeting on.
Understand. Well, glad you're here. Okay, so welcome to Sean and welcome to Terry and welcome to everyone else who's here again. It's awesome. All right, let's have updates. Let's open it. Anyone want to share where they're at? And if you don't, I will be throwing you under the bus. So better volunteer.
I don't want to end up under a bus.
So. Okay, so Glenda is going to go. Awesome.
I'm happy to start. Before I end up on a bus. Yeah, I'm getting to the pointy end of my book at the moment, which is really exciting. So I have my cover design finalized, which I'm really, really happy with. So long and short, actually, funny enough, when Andrew was saying about this group, I was thinking about yesterday, I was writing my acknowledgements, I'm calling it gratitude, but I was so sort of talking about my fellow authors. And I mean, you guys are definitely have been part of the journey to get me to the point where the manuscript is almost finished, the cover's done, and I should have it out in the world early next year. So, right. Yeah, partly it's exciting. Thanks, Andrew. Thanks to the rest of you for even getting me to this point.
Wow, thank you. Well, you're welcome for sure, but you did it. You did the work. You've done everything to get to this point. So congrats. That's so good. You haven't got the cover design, but you haven't printed it off for
No, it's still under wraps. So the only people that know the cover designer, the publisher, and my husband at the moment. You're talking about the marketing. That's going to be the next. I've decided the book's actually the easy part. Now it's the marketing. It's going to be the challenging bit.
Well, so. I think I've always said getting your book written, really, that gets you to ground zero. That's when it all starts, having a book.
Yeah.
You can't do anything without it, and everything starts once you've got it. So it's the fun stuff.
Yeah, so that's how
we won't say hard work, Glenda. Let's say the adventure begins. How's that sound?
That's it. It's a different part of the adventure. But I just want to encourage people, though, because, I mean, Andrew knows that I've had my moments where I've chucked my hands up in the air and said, I'm not going to do this anymore. And I don't know how many times that's happened. It's like, I can't do it. I can't do it. And persistence pays. And I'm a marathon runner and I see things through. People helping me and believing in me. My own, I don't let things beat me. So I had to keep reminding myself, considering that's part of kind of what the book is to a large degree about is getting stuff done. So I couldn't actually not get it done. So, but people made a, you know, people encouraging me and pushing me along the way has been a large part of it. So, yeah. So I just encourage when you do have the down, I think what I did is there were hiatuses where I just decided for a month, I'm not doing it. And I took a break. And then when I went back to it, I had a new level of enthusiasm. So I did find that helped if I was just going through times where it just wasn't happening. And I know that doesn't work for everybody. I just said, no, I'm going to take a time off. And then when I was ready, I went back to it and got a new kind of sense of momentum.
That's awesome. And I think it's fair to say every single one of us here in the room has faced discouragement at some point of our journey, even if you're right at the beginning. Yeah. And it's probably fair to say that every one of us has felt like sticking the book in the toilet and flushing it. And even if you've published your book, you've probably got to the point where you think, how am I ever, and I know there's a couple of people here that, how am I going to sell this? And is it ever going to do anything that I want it to do? And we all have those feelings, all right? So if you're having that feeling, guess what? You are right on track, you know, and it's just what you then do with that emotion, which Glenda so beautifully said, is just reconnect with the right people, have a hiatus if you need to have a hiatus, but never, ever, ever let go of that vision and that dream, because that's every achievement is the culmination of a lot of flipping frustration and a lot of persistence and a lot of overcoming. That's all it is, right? Like every one of us are here at this point because of the things we've overcome. So you can do this. This is nothing. This is the easy bit. But well done, Glenda. That's incredibly exciting. We can't wait to see your book and see it do amazing things in the world. So well done.
Thanks, Andrew.
Okay, well, that's a good start. Anyone want to try and beat that, top that? No, it's not about topping. It's about adding to that. Who wants to add to that? Don't make me do it.
I can spin it off in the exact opposite direction if you want, as you know.
Okay, just share it, Kat. We want to hear from you.
So I officially quit my book, but this is an agreed good thing. So for those who haven't been on this journey, I kicked off almost 3 years ago, actually maybe a little bit longer now, a project with a former coworker. We were designing a set of activities to teach kids or anyone physics concepts through, basically that we had created a bunch of activities that you would do. The physics that you used in the activities, like the leftover of that was art, effectively. So these different activities, for example, we attached textures, markers to a fidget spinner, spun it inside a box. And so you get these art splatter works, but that was teaching different forces and whatnot. So we had designed everything, we created all the activities, I'd written everything, I'd touched the book for something like 600 and whatever days in a row. And then we got to the next stages where I needed physics reviews through a person who I tried to engage through money, but they wanted to just, now I could pay him in books and all the rest of it. And then my partner as well was supposed to be, sorry, my book partner was supposed to be doing his bits. And for the last basically 2 years, it has been me trying to pull tooth and nail out of these people to get across it. And I started to hate everything about it, including writing, which was a huge passion of mine for years and a massive hobby. And I basically stopped writing full stop, wasn't working on the book, wasn't doing anything. And other than these weekly chasings of these people, and after yet another partner didn't show up and got a message the next day saying, oh, he thought the time zones were going to be fine, but he was an American. He'd gotten it wrong and didn't even bother letting me know he was going to be out of the country for a while. I just went, I can't do this anymore. The vision was gone. And it, to your point, Glenda, about like writing the book is only a piece of it. I was going to be bound to these irresponsible humans forever, trying to, market and pull them along for life effectively. And it felt like an unpaid job that I hated. I didn't want to do it anymore. So I set it down and let the writing partner know in response to my message said, look, he admits that he let it slide and he was going to make it a priority, but he's not sure how long that was going to last. And, it was just confirmation that this needs to go on a shelf and maybe someday it'll come back off that shelf, but that was the right thing to do. And in that conversation last month with Andrew, let me know. I'm not going to steal any of your thunder, Gemma, but Andrew let me know what Gemma was up to this month. And he suggested, oh, maybe I want to do the same. I was like, no, I'm not writing a novel this month. That's not what's going to happen. But I did really like the idea of doing something again with writing and a daily challenge and something. I can't touch the book every day because I didn't have a book. So instead, I used a combination of my old stored you know, lines that you keep for yourself, like, oh, that'd be a cool writing prompt, and ChatGPT and a couple other things. And I have made a set of writing prompts that are all on little pieces of paper, and I'm doing a daily lucky dip where I grab one of those out and then write. So I've finished a couple of short stories. I've started a couple of other things that are just whatever they are. As soon as I've done one or two where I've gone multiple days on it, and then set it aside for long. So I don't want to get too stuck into any one thing. But yeah, I'm doing that. It's been so much fun. I've been able to write, you know, some days it's just a couple of words, because that's all, I don't know, not all the prompts work for me every day, but I've, like I said, I've finished the whole stories I've written for 3 hours straight, with just like rekindled that spirit and that enjoyment. And who knows if anything will come out of this. I don't really care right now. But yeah, so it's been a real pivot. So the project that I was kind of, I guess, inside this group associated with, that one is, it's on ice. It's in perma for us. But it was really, really necessary. And it's been, incredibly cathartic and incredibly worth it. And yeah, I'm finally remembering why I went to Andrew's first, the first thing I ever went to Andrew's with writing, which was like, Gemma was there. I don't know if you remember when that was. It was about, like, I don't know, what, 9 plus years ago?
15 or something like that.
Yeah, something like that. So, you know, it was nice to get back to, back in touch with some of the energy I had way back when I, you know, liked writing. So, yeah, that's well, thanks, where I'm up to.
No, that's awesome. And I think there's a really good message there. And, you know, we say persist and keep going. But there are times when you quitting's the right thing to do, right? Like, and you know, Kat and I speak every month, and, you know, I've seen her frustration with trying to deal with people that are just not playing the game, or she's carrying the load. And yeah, so, and it wasn't even a project. I know for you, Kat, it wasn't really your passion. It was just a suggestion to you. Hey, do you want to be a part of this? So you said, yeah, I will. So you've made the right decision, and now you can be free to rekindle that love of writing again, hey, which I think you're doing beautifully. So now, Gem, do you want to tell us how you're going? So now Gemma has made a decision to write a whole novel in the month of November. And we're nearly halfway through November, so hoping you're nearly halfway through your novel, Jim. How's that going?
Yeah, really good, actually. So I was actually writing after I finished work and before we kicked off today. So I've scheduled out a book that is 23 chapters long. So it's going to be around about... So most of my chapters are around 2,500, so roughly in the realm of about 58,000-ish, 60,000 words, roughly, give or take a few. So that is the current plan. So I'm 11 chapters in, and so I've done about 27,000 words in the first 14 days of the month. So
awesome.
I am very much on track to actually get this completed by the 30th of November. Probably not before, but probably
mid 11:59 p.m. on the 30th of November. Yeah. Jeff will write the end.
Yes, pretty much.
That's uni assignment 11:59. You'll have it done.
That's exactly right. Doesn't really matter as long as it's just skates in at just that last minute of the day. So yeah, it's been challenging to push myself to shift up. I would do on average, you know, maybe half an hour or 500 words per day previously, to shift up to about 2,000 words per day. It is a big time commitment some days, and it can be difficult when you have a very tough day with work and other activities. But I have sat at my desk at 10 o'clock at night and punched out 2,000 words over the next 2 hours, and sort of called it a night quite late in. But I think what it's done for me is proven that, one, I've got more time in my day than I always let myself think I have.
Yeah.
I'm my own worst enemy on that front. But two, what it's actually done is completely rekindled my love when I'm in a flow. So there has been a couple of days where it has been a stilted 2,000 words, and it's taken me a little longer to get through that. But then there have been other days when I've sat here and I've just punched it out, and it's just been really fun. So I've actually, I made the decision to start a brand new series rather than try and pick up one or work on another book that I'd already been looking at. And so once I started scoping that out, it's probably going to be a 4-book series by the end of it. And so I'm probably going to get this one written, get it edited over the next month, and then I'll probably move straight into writing book 2 probably in January or thereabouts, so that I can keep the momentum going, so that probably not one a month, but probably one in sort of every 3 to 6 months will probably be my new goal moving forward.
Awesome. That's so good, Jim. So Jim, for people that don't know, Jim is already a very successful published author. You've got 3 books, haven't you? Trilogy of 3 books. Jim, question. So when you're in a flow, when you said there are days when you're in the flow and you're 2,000 words, just when you're in that flow, how long does it take you to write 2,000 words?
An hour.
And when it's stilted, how long does it take?
2 to 3.
Wow, isn't that interesting?
Wow.
Shows when, and this is the power of, I think, and this is an important message. When you do, my belief is when you write every day, it's easy to get into this flow. It's when you go, well, I'll do 3 hours on every weekend, it's way harder to get into the flow because you've got to go back and you've got to remember. But if you do it on a daily basis, it's much easier to get into that flow, and you'll find that. Is that what you find, Jim, now that you're doing it every day?
It is, yeah. It because I don't have to. When I'm a little bit disjointed with my writing, I have to go back and read where I'm at in the chapter. I sometimes have to go back and recheck where I'm at with my plan, whether the points are actually on par. Because I'm a fantasy writer, sometimes I let my story tell itself at times. So I give myself a guide to work from, but I free type everything. I don't actually reread the book until it's finished. And so it's all about getting the entire story out and then coming back at the end of it and going, how has this worked? And editing at that point in time. And it can be, I can lose my voice if I take too much time away from it. And I found that the book itself requires a lot more editing to pull certain parts together in order to make it feel like it's one voice that's going throughout that path. But if I'm actually touching it every day, I can just pick up and start to type rather than having to go back, spend the first 15 minutes reading what I wrote the last 2 times to remember what I've done with the storyline and where the characters are sitting.
Yeah.
Wow.
Hats off to you, Jim. I don't know how you write fiction, fantasy, like, oh my gosh. Just the creativity that must happen for you to get into that space is mind-blowing. So congrats. That's awesome.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Great job. Look forward to hearing about that, what you've done next time we catch up. All right. Anyone else want to share thoughts, ideas? Jean, hello.
Good morning from sunny South Africa. I want to add that whilst I wasn't at the last forum, well, for longer than 5 minutes, Sue and I have been chatting on a weekly basis, and Sue did mention Gemma's, I don't know if it was a challenge or if it was a goal, but I got on the bandwagon along with your idea, Gemma, and I'm sitting at 21,698 words in my murder mystery.
In November?
Yeah.
That's awesome, Jane. Well done.
I'm so happy that I've had Sue in my life because my biggest cheerleader. It's just been amazing. So yeah, I'm very excited.
Well done, Jane. That's amazing. Oh, Sue, let's hear your perspective on this journey. Yes.
We knock back and forth a whole load of concepts, don't we, G? Kind of motivational stuff and where we're at emotionally, the obstacles that we're facing, life, all that kind of stuff. And G's been battling with various concepts of books. So a book that she started with and then a book that kind of popped up. And then it was just in a conversation and I could just see the lights switch on. I think, and then it just went from there, wasn't it? And we've just been back. I'm in a different place, but Jean's been amazing, you know, just sitting there listening to where I'm at, working out where I'm at, what I'm doing, and just kind of metaphorically, I think I'm building the little kindling at the base of the fire at the moment. It's just not quite taken off, you know, I'm kind of getting it all kind of understood. And but no, I mean, we have great sessions. We actually need to have another one, don't we? We're due another one.
Yeah, we are.
But yeah, so I'm so pleased. Dude, it's just awesome. We get little kind of texts through. So I can't, I was reflecting on it this morning, actually, because of my kind of motivational swings and roundabouts. But Jean's been, you know, our sessions, a buddy is incredibly powerful. You know, whether you're really on it or not, it's if you've got a buddy that's kind of got your back, then it's powerful. And then coming back to this, which kind of realigns, you know, this group, you know, what you're actually doing. So you're not kind of going off track into so many other things you can go off track with a conversation. It ends up always coming back to the book. So there is a joint kind of intention behind our session. So, yeah, really, really recommend buddying up. Wherever you're at, whether you're, you know, literally below ground zero to, you know, in the sky, really, really recommend it. So it's been great. Yeah, that's my bit.
Good on you. Thanks. So, and it just shows, doesn't it, that no matter where you're at, you can help others. You know, and Sue's been able to help Jean, and maybe Sue's not at that point yet, but Sue, you will be at that point, and you'll be in the zone, writing thousands of words a day, which is just awesome. Well done, you guys.
Andrew, I was just going to jump in. It's very inspiring to hear Gemma and Jean's story, like literally in awe of you writing that many words. And you know, Sue was talking about motivation. And one of the books that I've really enjoyed reading earlier this year was by Dr. Ailette Fishback. And the book's called Get It Done. But the front cover says forget, but she's crossed out the four. And then it then says quit, but she's crossed out the QU and so on. So it comes out to get it done. But she talks about she's a motivational researcher, and she says motivation generally wanes the most in the middle. And so one thing to stop the waning in the middle is to have shorter goals. And I think it seems like Gemma and Jean have been energized by a 1 month is a shorter goal than a whole book or a year or 3 years and so on. And the other thing she talks about is celebrating the middles, you know, because generally you have enough motivation when you start because you've just come up with this idea and this goal. And so the first few days, no one ever misses November the 1st or the 2nd or the 3rd. And to some extent, when you're very close to the finish line, no one misses those couple of days because you're right there. There's only a chapter to go. But right in the middle, and we kind of, as you said, Andrew, couldn't be much closer to the middle. And so I just wanted to celebrate and, you know, congratulate Gemma and Jean on right in the middle of this shortish goal and how awesome. And so, you know, I'm inspired. So thank you. Lovely to hear that story.
Beautiful. Thanks, Justin, for that. While we've got Justin and Sue, Aussie Sue, let's hear, because you've just signed your contract, give us the update on when we're going to see your new book in there.
Well, thank you for the invitation. And Justin's here too. We're probably in the honeymoon period, aren't we, really, in the sense of we've signed the contract and we've gone up to the Melbourne offices of our publisher, Melbourne Books. We've met the publisher and his assistant and the IT person, all of that, and felt entered a world which we've been dying to enter for, as any would-be writers have been for a very long time. For me personally, coming through the teaching background, as Justin as well, me, the English teaching background, to walk into an office and feel the aura of the books and the occasion of having accepted and making a little ceremony. I took up new pens and gave us new pens, and I did all this deliberately to savour it, because listening to you guys and the rest of life experience, they're going to be tough times. But right now, I'm not in the frame to talk about tough times. I'm asked Justin. I'm in the tie me to the seat time. I'm so excited. When I came out of those offices, it was the end of Collins Street, the top end of Collins Street, the rare and antiquarian bookshop next door, the Sherlock Holmes Tavern and the Dickens Bar. And I said to Justin, just leave me here. I'll be right. Come back and get me in a week. I'll be fine. It just felt exhilarating. And we are now going through the process of feeling like we're actually real authors. And on Friday evening, we have an invitation from the publishers to come and celebrate being an author for Melbourne Books.
Wow.
What a thing. What a thing. Who would figure that was going to happen? So every little step, no matter how minute it might feel to others, there's who's got that up? Justin, have you got that up?
Andrew has.
Andrew, there we are, sitting there in the office, the publisher on the other side of the desk. There he is, David Tenenbaum and Sophie Gooden. He's a young assistant. And that intergenerational thing is so appealing as well, because she's up there with saying things like, I think we could get some of your exercises on TikTok. I'm going, oh, yeah, right, okay, tell us about that. You can do it. But we're up for anything. And they're sitting there and getting a bit excited. David and Justin said, we thought maybe an audio book as well. They got us down for an ebook and a paperback. And Justin said, what about an audio book? And they're going, oh, have we done that before? Well, maybe that's interesting. Maybe we'll look into that. You know, you hear all these stories about people being put off and rejections and waiting, and we're having the opposite. So it's a bit of a pinch me time. And when I'm in tears and come to the forum and you look at that and go, look at her, she was flying high, wasn't she? Look at her now, look at her now. That's okay too. I'm up for it, you know, being in my encore years, I'm calling this. I'm post my career. I have my grandchildren. I'm in retirement. And this wonderful Justin Robinson came along and said, how about you have a go at this? And you're talking about buddies. I had a co-author in Justin, and we made a joke of this, but I'm a morning worker and Justin's an evening worker. And I'd get up in the morning and we were using shared docs. Again, all this new stuff I'm learning is so cool. I get up in the morning and there's a new chapter and Justin's written it. I'm going, no.
That's a way to write a book, isn't it? Wake up in the morning and another chapter.
Way to write a book. And we're touching that app, you know, touch book when you do your chapter and it's pinging me when I'm out in the street or playing with the grandchildren. I go, whoa, I'm an author and it's happening. So yeah. I just want to say to all of you, this is also possible. It's not all doom and gloom. And there will be days that the sun doesn't shine. But right now, I don't care, you know? Just go for it.
Good on you. Yes. Awesome. So congrats. Love your energy. I think Thank Sue. You. UK you. Sue said love your energy.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Do you want to add to that, Justin?
Yeah, if I could just jump in to I love Sue's energy too. But to add to the forum and what Sue in the UK was saying about the importance of a buddy and support. And there's no doubt, Andrew, that your forum and your group have supported us. And
yeah.
Kat, who's on our call now, yeah. Sue, Kat and I just met for half an hour at 6:30, so just half an hour before. And Kat was one who very openly volunteered for us when we said we wanted people to road test our book. And we had kind of 20 plus road testers, and Kat was one of those. And we just met with Kat saying, can you help us with your experience of the book? What exercises worked? How did it feel? And I've got a page of notes from our meeting with Kat, and that again will enhance our book because we'll make some late little changes and tweaks and so on. So again, just thanking the kind of the collective group and the forum, and certainly continues to be a group effort to kind of produce our book, and I'm sure maybe to produce any book. And so very grateful for Kat particularly, but many others.
Ditto. Well done. Awesome. Justin.
Thanks, man. Wonderful. Wow. Some stuff happening, isn't it? There sure is. Who else has got something they would like to share or ask, or questions or concerns or challenges that you need help overcoming?
If I could make some kind of comment about, I think we had a conversation about this on a previous forum, and I seem to remember Sue bringing it up with AI, the using ChatGPT in writing. And it's come to the fore for me, not specifically for my book, but I actually had a bizarre situation in Italy. I had a friend of mine send me his manuscript and say, can you read it? I'm an Italian person. I've written a whole book using AI. I've read it through in Italian, but I'm not sure if it makes sense in English. And I thought, it's just amazing that somebody could use AI to generate a whole book in something that isn't their mother tongue. So I was then looking at, I was speaking to my publisher, but also just looking online and on Amazon. And it's interesting, there are obviously a whole ton of conversations happening with publishers at the moment. And Amazon apparently asks if you're going to self-publish whether you've used AI, but they distinguish between having used it to generate your stuff versus used it to, I don't know, to help you or whatever. And I just suspect that it's going to be one of those, and I'm sure a lot of you can say more than I can at this point, but it just seems to be becoming an increasing hot topic in terms of how AI gets used, doesn't get used, the limitations, the issues that come. Because one of the things that was raised with me is, if it gets to the point where whoever owns the AI engine actually decides that you've used too much and they actually essentially take the copyright from your book. I don't know what other people's experiences or thoughts or whatever are on this whole sort of AI space.
Well, it's a big topic. It's a big topic, for sure. And I don't know what other people's thoughts are. There are publishers out there that are saying, the question they're asking is, have you used AI to generate your manuscript? And they won't accept it. And and the bottom line is, I don't think you should be submitting anything that you haven't created. I mean,
I can just say, you know, I'm a third year uni student, and 12 months ago, AI really started to come into play. And so this time 12 months ago, a uni was saying, don't use it, we'll find you out, it's plagiarism, it's not right, don't use it. And within 6 months they have said, look, this is how you should use it. Mm-hmm. They have realized that they're not going to escape people using it. So if you are stuck in how to write an introduction, if you are stuck in what some bullet points I should be considering here, if you are, you know, stuck in how to do your conclusion, or you want to write it in a more academic thing, they are saying it is now considered to be a tool, but it's a tool that should be used for you to make some ideas, to set out some plans, and to go from there. It is not a tool that should be. The writing should still be belong to you, and I suppose that would be the same for this situation.
Yeah, I think so.
I think it is
disappointing.
Yes, Sean.
I do agree with you. I believe, as Andrew mentioned, it's a big topic. At the moment, we are using AI heavily in our area, and it's somehow it's a good friend of us. Help us a lot in the work that we are doing with our clients. But one thing, it's clear, because still there are a lot of improvement happened in the AI, and at least three times in the work, let's say from January so far, during the work that I have directly worked with, like ChatGPT, ChatGPT apologized for the work because AI has a big lack on experience. It means it can easily provide the content, fantastic writing, but there is no soul inside that. So if your book needs to work based on a story and experience to share, AI cannot help. But if we just want to talk about the logic, just talk about the bullet points. This is a step, this is a process. It can work easily because access to all the information available in the market. So I believe, as you mentioned, it is a strong tool that we can use to have some roadmap guideline to move forward. But still the part of that human element that you need to sit and bring soul, even if it is not, if it is, for example, you write a book about business, still you need to actually bring some level of experience and soul and fun inside that book, which AI cannot do at this stage.
Okay, that's awesome, mate. Thanks, Sean. And look, as I said, we could talk forever on AI. I don't want to. I mean, Kat's put a nice comment. Check the comment about legal precedent. I think from a, you know, just be sensible with it. You know, and I think we're all sensible people. I think you can use it for sure. It's a useful tool. It's not going to write your book, though. And I don't think anyone here would use it to write their book or content that should be personal and your own creativity. I mean, that's what a book is. So, but it was good. I mean, it's a very relevant topic for sure. And, you know, it's worthwhile just understanding it and how to use it effectively. So, go, John. You're on mute, mate. You'll have to unmute. Yep.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for saying.
Did you get lost in the hallway getting to your office, mate?
No, I was coming back from a meeting, so that's all right. But I did get here eventually.
You did, mate. Good to have you. Any exciting news in your front?
No, not really. I'm just being frustrated by the government's slowness in responding and coming up with different ideas on my National Road Safety Action Grants program, which I filled in diligently, and then I find out that I am required to supply 30% of the funding, which is pretty interesting when it's a government grant, and yet the people who are applying for the government grants are supposed to supply 30% of the funding, and there was nothing said about that initially. So, yes.
So,
just another challenge to
you'll get there, mate. You'll
I'll get there. That's right. Yes, exactly. So just another challenge.
Well, good luck with that one, mate. Good luck. Yeah. I'm sure
I'm addressing it, and I'm getting some
pretty
good support, which is good.
Awesome, mate. Awesome. What else? Anything else, guys? Any questions, thoughts, breakthroughs? Great conversation. What have you got? Okay. Sorry, Alice. Yes, please.
Yeah, I just wanted to ask for any tips about launching, how people have launched their books, if they're doing it self-published wise. Obviously, I'm doing the podcast now, so I've done about five. And so I'm just sort of getting used to speaking, really, and talking about my book. And a few people have asked me to sort of do talks or sort of launches, and I'm like, I really, really don't feel comfortable about standing up and talking to people. So, you know, in a sort of physical, you know, real people in the same room. So I was thinking, how do people do that? I mean, I can see it as doing it in a conversation. If someone's sort of chatting to you, like an interview, could be a lot easier. But say if somebody wants you to present your book, I'm sure everyone's done this. It's like, how would they go about doing that? I mean, do you just like introduce yourself and why you wrote the book and what it's about and all those sort of general sort of journalistic questions? Or does anyone have any sort of tips or
thoughts? I think it depends a little bit on the style and the avenue you're taking. So I've done three different book launches, and each of them was slightly different to the other. My third one was an online, and so I scoped that more as a Q&A type discussion. I had my sister host it with me, so I chose someone who I could trust to ask and help and manage the back end side of it. I didn't want to be handling questions via the chat, mm-hmm. So she would then present those questions to me. But I did a bit of a I guess, a snapshot. So I did a little bit of myself, a little bit about the book, a little bit about the background, and then opened it up a little bit more for forums and Q&As and discussions like that at the end. The in-person ones, the first one, I hosted it independently, and it was mainly just getting everyone I knew, getting everyone they knew to come and launch my first book. And then it was just talking a little bit about the passion as to why I started writing. But what I would suggest is prepare. No one's going to fault you if you have a speech. I'm a lot more confident now, not only because of my business work, but also the fact that I've now had three books. I'm a lot more confident talking publicly in those sorts of groups. But when I did my first one, I'm an introvert by nature. So people make me nervous when I'm in bigger groups. And so it can be a little bit daunting when you're not sure how to, what to say, how to do it. And so I wrote down my speech initially. I also did excerpts from the books. That's always a good idea. Prepare some excerpts to share with people about what your book actually covers, so they get a little bit of an idea of an insight as to who you are as a writer. My second one I actually did in tandem with a library, and that was actually really good. So they actually did the sort of Q&A in person. They prepared some questions for me. They gave them to me in advance, and I was able to actually prepare a little bit for that and able to do that. You don't have to talk a lot, because most of the time it's there about just starting the process going and going from that point on. And then you actually end up, for the initial stages, doing a lot of similar types of talks, because the book itself doesn't change. The reason you started writing doesn't change. And all the key elements within it don't change. So you can actually become more practiced as you go along answering those sorts of questions. So it depends in reality what you're most comfortable with as to which avenue you take, because each of them will be successful for different reasons.
That's awesome.
Brilliant.
And I think the message there is launches can take any shape or form you want them to take. There's no limits. You know, you can do them online, you can do them in cafes, you can do them in libraries, you can ring, you know, go to organizations, say, hey, do you want to host a launch? Go to bookshops, host a launch, go to a whole range of places and host a launch. One thing I will slightly disagree with, being uncomfortable is okay. So that fear that you've got, there's only one way to deal with it. And avoiding it's not it. You know, so I think getting a bit uncomfortable and Gemma said, you know, craft a plan a talk. You know, I'll help you with that. Just do it. And, you know, I know what it's like when you do your first talk and you go, oh my gosh, I forgot that and all the things, say that. Or the people listening don't know. They don't know what you plan to say. They don't know if you'd forgot. It doesn't matter. As Gemma said, you tell your story, you talk from your heart, you talk about your passion, you talk about why your book is going to have an impact on their lives. And trust me, you'll sell books and you'll inspire people. Just keep it.
Great.
John will add some great stuff to that. Sorry, Alice, did you want to say something?
No, that's great. I mean,
I'm not sure who's speaking then. Is it?
I'm not going to purport to be a launch expert because I'm still going with planning my launch, but I have to agree with Gemma and Andrew in terms of that preparation piece, because I'm a speaker as well as I train people on speaking, and preparation is often the thing that people forget to do because they know their topic so well, they think they can just stand up and speak about it. So Gemma, what you said about preparation, but I also agree with Andrew, that butterflies that you get before a talk is actually a good thing, because adrenaline is something that's designed as part of our body. But it's what we do with that adrenaline that's the important thing. So it's harnessing that adrenaline to give you energy with your audience rather than anything else. And then finally, I guess Andrew said he can help you with your talks. And again, he knows launches far better than I do. But I'm happy to put my hand up to help you if there's anything that I can help with from a sort of presentation skills, speaking skills, perspective, I'm happy to help you, Alice, if there's anything that I can do.
There you go. Awesome. Thanks, Glenda. And John. John's yes. The master of this stuff.
Sorry? No.
How many presentations have you done, John, since you started your school campaign? Do you reckon?
I've spoken to over 500,000 students and over 300,000 corporates, so I have no idea. That's over 25 years.
That's close to me.
I have no idea how many presentations I've given. So the result is the ones that have been listening, hopefully they've taken notice and they're being really good road users. That's what it's all about. I'm going to repeat something that I did last year, and this was only because I am a speaker and not someone who's good on the media in as far as on the internet. But what I did last year, I took my book, and there's 20, you remember the 25 Days to Christmas, the song and all of that type of thing? On the first day of Christmas, on the first day of December, I read on YouTube Mandy's introduction to my book. On the second day, I read another piece out of my book. On the third day, this is on YouTube, the third day, I read another piece of interest. And I sold a heck of a lot of books leading up to Christmas because my book is, I believe, the best Christmas gift at $20. That any parent or grandparent can give a child or a grandchild as a gift on Christmas Day. So I'm going to repeat that again, only this year I'm going to repeat it again on YouTube, but I'm also going to repeat it on TikTok because I give TikToks talks now at the end of every presentation that I give at a school, and some of those schools have had over 100,000 views of my TikTok talk, which only goes for, 5 minutes at the most at the end of the presentation. And I've accidentally called myself the oldest TikToker in the world, and it's really taken off. I've had phone calls from people who've seen me on TikTok and have Carmen's bookmark, and they say, oh, it's great to be talking to the oldest TikToker in the world again. And it's just really taken off. I play bowls. And there have been people at bowls in their 30s and 40s. And they said, oh, you're the oldest TikToker in the world. So they've seen it as well. So I'm going to redo my readings. So there will be 25 readings of my book leading up to Christmas. And at the very end, I have the screenshot where they can just go to my website and purchase the book for $20. Although this year, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a discount on there so they can get it for $15. And I believe that, especially for the students who are on TikTok, for them, a student can afford $15. When I go to the schools, they just pull out their phone and they hit it on my little reader and they pay $20, no problems at school. So that's another way of selling and promoting. That's promoting myself. So I know that even on TikTok, 100,000 viewers of my TikToks will see me again and hear my book again.
That's awesome, John. That's awesome.
Well, it's different.
Always innovating you are. I love it. I love it. The oldest TikToker. He's a bit of a rocker too. TikToker. Hello, Chris. You've come for the powerful last 5 minutes of this forum.
I've got the timing completely wrong because the clocks have gone back here.
Yeah.
So I should have been here at 8 o'clock in the morning, shouldn't I?
Yeah, you should have. That's okay.
And I've really missed something that's bloody amazing. I've really missed something here.
That's right, mate. Well, you can watch the recording.
Yeah.
Anyway, good to see your face. So sorry to do this to you, Chris, but we're about to wrap up. Chris, hang around when we finish, right? Because I want to just have a chat to you. But
oh, okay.
I just want to say thank you, everyone. It's been awesome. Like, this has been such a good forum, and thanks everyone for who's contributed. Congratulations for everyone on what you're doing. Whether you feel like you're doing something or not, you are. You know, again, I can't emphasize enough just the importance of showing up. Show up, even when you don't feel like it, even when you feel like maybe things aren't going the way you want, you're getting frustrated, show up. So these forums are here for you, but you know, I'm here for you. You know, you can connect with each other, as you heard, that Sue and June have connected, and that's they're helping each other. And, you know, this is a community and we're here to help each other. And so awesome to be with you all. So have a wonderful month of, where are we? We're in November. Gosh, the next forum we do will be the last one of 2023. So it'll be in 4 weeks.
So, Andrew, just before I go, or before we all go, I've just uploaded my TikTok on the chat.
Okay.
And it's just tiktok.com@Carmen's Legacy. So if everybody wants to have a look, they'll see that they'll see how stupid I am on TikTok. But anyway, that's great, and that's what the kids love. They love to see some excitement. Some, you know, I get kids come on there and say, "Who is this guy?" You know. Which is great, because that creates the association between a really old person and a really young person.
Yeah, that's awesome. Good on you, mate. Superstar. All right, guys. Thank you so much. Everyone. I'll see you.
Thanks, everyone. Thanks, everyone.
Have a beautiful week. Have a beautiful night.
Bye.
See ya.
Bye.